Welcome today to your tutorial on how to create tables in Microsoft Word. My name is Steven, and throughout the next 5 to 10 minutes, we will be learning how to create an effective layout and design for any type of table you may want. We will go more into detail about some than others, but after this lesson, you should be prepared to create a table for a project, a calendar of events, or even grocery lists, so let's get started. You can start off by bringing your cursor over the Insert option on the menu here, and then click on it. Once you do so, a Tables option will then appear for you to choose. Once you click on Table, a menu will then drop down and you will be provided with some ways to create a different type of table. If you highlight over the grid provided for you here, you'll notice how the table you choose depending on the number of rows and columns you select will be shown on the document to your right. You also have the option to draw a table, but doing this option will not allow you to have individual cells for information to go into. However, you will be able to add cells later if you like. The Quick Tables link located at the bottom here will allow you to create calendars, grocery lists, double tables, and much more. For now, we are going to click on the Insert Table option. If we want a table bigger than the area that was previously provided on the first grid, we will choose this option because it is a more effective choice to use. Once you click on Insert Table option here, you will be provided with some information you need to fill out. Once you determine the number of rows or columns you need, click OK. For now, I have provided a table with you on the document already, so I won't worry about clicking on OK. I'm just going to click Cancel, and I will use that as an example throughout the rest of this lesson. If you find out that you need more columns or rows, you'll be able to do those later. We'll go into this a little bit more throughout the lesson. If at any point you would like to edit part of your table, you will need to make sure you highlight or click the inside of your table like this. Just be careful where you click so you're not making changes to a part of a table you don't want to. To make changes to the entire table at once, you can move your cursor to the top left corner of your table right here and find a little box with four direction arrows in it. By clicking on that, it will highlight the entire table. When you click on the box and the table is highlighted, two tabs will appear towards the top right corner that say Design and Layout. We will begin by clicking on the Design tab. Although we want to figure out our layout for the table before we go into the detail about designing it, I find it more helpful to pick the table style first located here and then determine our layout. Looking in this table styles group, the table style farthest to the left is the default one right here. If you choose to go with another style, you can just click any of these options next to it. If you don't want to scroll down using the arrow right here like this, the one right below this one will open up the entire tab to show you all the options for your table styles located like that. Your styles will vary based on whether or not you draw or insert a table. You will notice that the borders don't show up. Seeing right now are these grid lines that I had chosen from this option over here under the Layout tab. You could press View Grid Lines to show the borders of the cells that weren't originally there at once. If I were to unclick this one, you could see that those borders do go away. It is nice because when you do choose some of these options, they don't necessarily have borders, but when you click on View Grid Lines, they provide that extra space for you to show where your boundaries for each. Even though we have these grid lines here on the cells at the moment for our boundaries, if you were to go ahead and print it, those lines will not show up. They're just there as guidelines right now. If I were to go back to this Design tab here and look at the option for borders next to Table Styles, you can add different borders if you want, so they would show up when printing out your information. Before we go back to more in-depth description of design, we'll talk about the layout of your table, so go ahead and switch over to the Layout tab over here for now. See across this ribbon under the Layout tab that there are a lot of options, but they all are really easy to use. You may find out at some point that you might need to insert another column or row to your table. We can do this by clicking any one of these options in the rows and columns groups listed here. If you want them in a certain place, you can either highlight an entire column or an entire row, depending on where you want to put your information. You can even click on one individual cell or go up to the corner here where a select option in the cursor is located. If you do this, you could select the column, and wherever you previously clicked in a certain cell, it will highlight that entire column. You would then be able to go up to the options here under rows and columns and click Insert Left or Right if you want to add a column to that certain area there. Even though I selected to insert an extra column right there, the same process will go about for inserting an extra row above or below. Just come up here to insert below or above, Do the same thing that you would normally with another column.
Next to the rows and columns group, you can find a group where you can merge cells together. This will allow you to combine more than one cell in a column or row into one single cell like this. By selecting these two cells and clicking the Merge Cells tab, it will make it one cell together. You need to make sure you highlight more than one cell for this to work, and then Merge Cells tab. Splitting a cell allows you to make a cell into multiple ones. Instructions for this are the same as merging cells, except you don't necessarily need to highlight more than one cell. While clicking on the Split Cells tab, it will ask you to put a number of rows and columns you want your cells to be in now. Again, this depends on the type of table you want. It isn't useful for every table you create, and that goes with a lot of details we have talked about previously. I'm going to go and click OK, so it would just go ahead and change my cells back to normal to where it originally was. Next, you can change the height or width of each of your cell. Your default settings are shown here, but if you want to make them larger or smaller, click the up or down arrow next to your option. Another easy way to do this is by putting your cursor on the table border and clicking and dragging it to resize, like this. These nine options listed above the alignment here will allow you to put your information into a certain area within that particular cell. This is helpful if you want to align your information within that single cell. Since the cell is acting as one row, you can distribute it across the cell like this. If you are making the cell bigger by just pressing Enter, you are creating multiple rows, so your information will not be distributed around the cell, but only in that one particular row. The next option is more helpful when you may be making a check-in list of, let's say, names, items, or places to go eat. It can be whatever, but this sort button in the data group will allow you to sort your information alphabetically. For more information on sorting options in a table, refer to the Excel screencast done by Andrea. It pretty much works the same way in the table for Microsoft Word. The last thing I want to point out under layout and data here is the formula option. If you have a list of data that requires mathematics, you can create a formula for that last cell, so all the math will be done for you and the total amount will be added. For more information on formulas and functions, check out Kelly Hopper's screencast that talks about this in Excel. Now that we've pretty much mentioned everything you need to know under layout for your table, we can go back to the Design tab and learn about how to make a more presentable table. So we have our basic design and style for our table here. These next options can help us spice it up a little bit more. To your left, you can see table style options. Some of the options may be checked and some may not be. If you really haven't set up your table besides inserting it, you can see a preview of what each looks like, checked or not, if you look at the tables being displayed under table styles. It all depends on the style you choose. These options can get a little complex, so I would recommend taking some time to view some tips under help to learn a little bit more and simply explore your options if you have some extra time. There are a lot more cool options you can use to create your tables under design. I encourage you to check them out to see which one of them you prefer. You can add borders to your cells if you choose a table that doesn't originally have them. The borders can be added to one side at a time, all at once, diagonally, or many other ways as you can see listed here under this option listed. Just remember to highlight the right number of cells in order to work. Most of them will work for only one or two cells, but inside borders requires four cells highlighted in order for it to work. I'll give you a few examples here. If I have these four cells highlighted right here, and I go ahead and click the inside borders, it will only highlight the borders inside those four cells. If I want the whole entire borders all around the cells highlighted, I would click all borders, and it will highlight all the borders around the entire cells. If I was going to go ahead and try the same option with just the one cell here after I highlight, going back up the borders and click inside borders, obviously you can't do it with just one cell because there aren't any borders inside that cell. You can also change your border colors and styles by coming up to draw borders over here. You can scroll down either one of these options to get a better color of a border that you may want, or you could draw the thickness of the line a little bit more by going here. And then you'll see this little pencil mark that comes up, and you could click on either of the borders here, and it will display a thicker line and one in a different color too. Search through these options to find which ones may be more appealing to you. So we just went over a lot of information about design layout for tables. If you get confused along the way, just drag your cursor over any of these options. you will get a little bit of a description of what it will do for you. Right-clicking the mouse inside the table will also list a lot of table options for you there, so you won't have to go back and forth between the design and layout tabs. Once you have the time to figure out the type of table you were trying to create for your data, and you figure out the type of borders you want, the table style and everything, you can come up with some really cool table presentations as the ones listed here, whether it is a calendar, items list, or information regarding different colleges, campuses, whatever the information will be. So I know you guys learned a lot here, and I will leave you alone and let you get creating your own table. So best of luck in all that you're doing.